How does one get to be low in testosterone? Are there ways to improve it naturally without needing testosterone replacement? It's really important to get to the root cause and fix it from the ground up naturally. This is the Dr. Lam Show, and we're here to talk about integrative medicine, as well as empowering you to take control of your health. If you enjoy the show and find it useful, please hit the like button and subscribe to the Dr. Lam Show podcast, as well as the YouTube channel. This is the best way to make this show more visible so that other people who need the information can find it. I'm Dr. Jeremy Lam. I'm an internal medicine physician, and I'm also board certified in anti-aging and regenerative medicine. And I've spent my medical career working on chronic disease treatment and prevention. And I firmly believe in the power of integrative medicine.
And I'm Dr. Carrie Lam, family medicine physician, and I've completed fellowships in functional and metabolic medicine. And I'm also passionate about nutrition and lifestyle medicine. Today, we're going to be talking about how to improve testosterone naturally. So to start off with, let's talk about what testosterone is so that we're actually all on the same page. Dr. Jeremy, tell us what testosterone is.
Well, testosterone is actually, you know, the male hormone, and it's opposite to estrogen. So both females and males actually make testosterone, and it helps with in energy, it helps in fertility, it also helps in muscle, bone mass, as well as just overall well-being. And so a lot of females nowadays are actually also being given testosterone because females do need an optimal level of testosterone, not only males. And so let's talk about, you know, why testosterone goes down both in males and females.
Yeah, so adrenals actually are one part of the organs that actually make testosterone. Your gonads might be also the other part in males that make testosterone. And in females, mostly the adrenals are the parts that make it testosterone. As you grow older and your gonads start to fail, as males undergo male pause, menopause, and women undergo menopause, the adrenals are the only one that can make testosterone, actually. The adrenals start off with cholesterol, and it can go down the line and make progesterone, and it can go down the line and make DHEA, testosterone, estradiol, and cortisol. And so testosterone usually hits its peak around 30 years of age and then has a gradual decline by natural progression. And so it's a natural happening to actually see testosterone lower over time. However, when your body is extra stressed, causing your adrenals to become fatigued, you might have a more difficult case making testosterone. Okay, as more of your more of the hormones are shunted to make cortisol, which is to help reduce inflammation, to help you deal with stress and that fight or flight response. And so therefore, those with adrenal fatigue tend to have less testosterone to work with.
So what you're trying to say, Dr. Carey, is that instead of making right the sex hormones when your body is stressed, it tries to make more cortisol instead. Mm-hmm. Because the body doesn't perceive reproduction as a high priority, right? When it's under stress, it wants to be able to fight off the inflammation and wants to work on your immune system. Right. So it's going to put your reproductive system on a back burner. And so when you're trying to survive, so automatically, you know, your libido gets shut off as well as your testosterone. And not only testosterone, but also other reproductive hormones also take a back seat. So that's why women can also miss their cycles when their body's under stress, right? Even if, let's say you're running a long marathon, and for a woman's body, it can be quite stressful as well if they're not ready. And so they can have skipped periods, which is not unusual. And so I just mentioned that low libido is a sign of low testosterone. What other signs might people look for when their testosterone is low, Dr. Carey?
Loss of muscle mass is one of the signs of testosterone, and loss of strength. If you were able to do some heavy lifting before, whether it's dumbbells, and this can apply to both males and females, it's not sex specific. When testosterone levels go down, your anabolic processes also go down. Anabolic means muscle building. And so when you're unable to build muscles as well, you feel a little weaker. And so not only does age affect your decrease in testosterone, but also being overweight can cause extra fat to actually produce more estrogen, because fat produces estrogen, which then actually lowers your testosterone ratio also. And there are other things that can lower testosterone, Dr. Jeremy. How does diet come into play?
Well, you know, excess sugar leads to insulin resistance. And so when you are resistant to insulin, that can also have less of a testosterone effect in your body because of the excess sugar. And so combining all of this, it's first very important, right, to kind of figure out why your testosterone is low. And then once we figure it out, what can we do naturally to help increase the testosterone? And the first thing that you can do is to reduce stress. And I think that's quite obvious. And oftentimes giving the body the proper rest will be able to redirect the adrenal pathways. So the need to make cortisol reduces because there's less stress. And so then there's less anti-stress hormone required. And so then pregnenolone, which is the grandmother of all the anabolic hormones, will then shunt automatically towards making more testosterone. And this is an automatic process that your body responds to when you help it with decreasing stress. It's automatic, and so that's one way that you can do it. So not only decreasing stress is important, but also trying to get more sleep as well is important in that way. What's another way, Dr. Carey, that we can naturally increase testosterone?
Yes, perhaps the easiest way to increase testosterone and also growth hormone, as they go kind of hand in hand, is to do muscle exercises, big muscle groups like pull-ups or push-ups, where you're using these big muscles and not just your finger muscles or your wrist muscles, as they are small. These big muscle groups like push-ups or pull-ups or your thighs and your trapezius muscles, the body automatically will activate this anabolic process. So your testosterone, especially growth hormone, also tends to rise, and it starts to help your muscle build, and therefore cellular testosterone can also increase. And so exercise is very important in helping to build testosterone, but you have to be very careful if you have adrenal fatigue to not overdo it. As we mentioned before, that there are certain athletes, they tend to have hormone imbalance if they over-exercise. So always making sure that you listen to your body, and if it's overworked and tired after a workout, you really have to evaluate if you're pushing your adrenals too much, because then you can also therefore reduce the testosterone output from there. So Dr. Jeremy, tell us about certain foods that can also increase testosterone.
Well, foods that are high in magnesium as well as high in zinc can help naturally improve testosterone. So you want to make sure you look those up, the foods that are high in magnesium and zinc. Other things that can increase your testosterone naturally are items such as tuna, low-fat milk, egg yolks, oysters, shellfish, beef, and beans. All those can help to naturally increase your testosterone. So you want to increase the intake of those foods if that's what you're suffering from.
As you can tell, improving testosterone naturally isn't as simple as taking hormones and going on with your life. Every circuit and organ in your body is connected, so a major change in one of them can have numerous and unexpected effects. And if you're struggling with these kinds of changes, definitely give our office a call, 714-709-8000, and we can give you specialized information on how to improve your testosterone naturally. Now we're going to go more deeply into these changes and look at the health problems and symptoms associated with hormone disruption.
So when your body encounters stress and you are dealing with adrenal fatigue, cortisol production goes down, as well as testosterone, or in females, you have estrogen dysregulation. And so you might have all this ovarian adrenal thyroid or this gonadal adrenal thyroid axis that's affected. And so when your body is stressed, your thyroid is going to be affected as well, right? When one organ system is off, the other two are going to be off, just like it's a three-legged stool. And so if one leg is already not working properly, you're not going to be able to sit on that stool properly. And so that's why a lot of people, despite being on thyroid replacement, they don't feel good. In fact, about one third or more people that are on thyroid medication still need some form of an adjustment. And many actually eventually cannot make it through the thyroid replacement for that reason, because they're either missing the underlying adrenal component or the underlying hormonal, whether it's testosterone or estrogen component as well. Right, without attending to the adrenal side, trying to balance hormones can actually be quite challenging.
Right, we see a lot of people actually come to see us on already testosterone replacement, on thyroid medication, but they're still not feeling better. They still have low libido and they're like, why? I'm on all these hormones and I should be feeling much better and I should have more energy. The reason why is because they're not really getting to that three-legged stool. Like you said, there's the adrenals, the thyroid, and the hormones. So instead of just stimulating yourself more with testosterone replacement or bioidentical hormone replacement, you have to make sure that your adrenals are also well taken care of first as one of the three-legged stools. And so if you're still feeling like there's something wrong, even though you're on these all these hormone treatments, then you might be having this hormone imbalance and you have to get to the down to the root cause. And we hope that we can help you with this, as testosterone imbalance can be ignored by conventional medicine, or you might be on the wrong medication if you're not fixing your adrenals or your thyroid. And so this can lead to long-term debilitation and poor health. So remember, if you think something is wrong, don't stop searching until you get help and guidance that you need. And we are so happy that you're here on the Dr. Lam Show today, and we hope you can find this information helpful. If you did, please subscribe to this channel so that we can continue to bring you more great content. If you know anyone else who would like to listen to this, make sure you share it with them. Remember, we're here to empower you to take control of your health.